That was always just my whole mindset. It's the mentality. Mentality was always to be a go-getter. I always call myself a OGG. So I'm an original go-getter.
Don't forget to smash that share button. Subscribe to my page. Follow me on Instagram at Lance Bachman and keep sending me those questions. Hey, everybody. I'm excited to have Alonzo Adam here on the den today, founder and president of Busy Bee Cleaning Company out of Westchester, to talk about the impact of what the virus is having on his company, what he's seeing, and also being an African-American leader and entrepreneur who's very successful and a lot of people look up to. Alonzo, thank you so much for being on the show.
Hey, thank you for having me. I'm looking forward to it.
You built this from the ground up. You struggled to get here. We're going to talk about some of the challenges you had, especially being an African-American starting a company as a teenage father in 1992 when things were a lot different in this country than now, right? Can you talk about the impact of what's happening in your company right now?
Well, with this virus is now, it's people are rocked. You know, people are looking to the left, they're looking to the right. They're just trying to find direction. And right now, our businesses, one of our businesses, we go into homes. And so going into homes, we know people are quarantined. And with people being quarantined, they're just not so open to let you into their home to clean their personal space. So that's been a challenge to us because we have seen a drop off because, again, people are not comfortable with us coming into the home. So our business has fell off somewhere between 60 to 65%.
That's a staggering number. I'm assuming you had to lay people off. Is that correct?
Well, what we actually have been doing, we've been rotating. So okay. we're open 3 days a week. And so we talked to the staff, we had a meeting, and we rotate them in and out.
So you know how I feel about bankers. You know how I feel about that whole industry. You go to two different banks, Fulton Bank, Santander Bank. You apply for the PPP loan. You don't hear anything back in return whatsoever until a few days ago they say all the funds are gone. Is that accurate?
That is correct. You know, Fulton is my bank. That's my main bank. And I was real disappointed that here's the thing. It was no approach as the local bank to actually take care of the local business owner. So it was, they quickly told me, it's like, listen, we're done. We're full right now. So I reached out to Santander because I have a line of credit with Santander. And they did seem more accommodating than Fulton Bank, unfortunately. I just felt as though they were very laid back, nonchalant. They didn't feel as though they needed to step up. You know, you're looking for, if that's your bank, they got your back. They got you covered. And I just didn't feel that.
Alonzo, me and you got to know each other. I did some research on you. Busy Bee is not your only company. You own several properties. You're quite a success story. You had your first son as a teenager. He's 30 years old. Mine's 29 years old. We started laughing about that. An African-American male starting a company, and they grow up to be one of the biggest cleaning companies in the state of Pennsylvania. It's kudos to you. I mean, I just congratulations on all your success there. Thank you. What was it like? Hey, can you tell the young viewers that want to be the next Alonzo, what is it like?
Well, the one thing is that whatever I was going to do, I was definitely going to be the best at it. That was always just my whole mindset. It's the mentality. Mentality was always to be a go-getter. I always call myself a OGG. So I'm an original go-getter. So I decided once I was going to go out there and go for it, nothing was going to stop me. But if I was going to do anything, it was all going to be based off of excellence. And I know it always starts with people. Everything starts with people. So anyone that I was going to be associate myself with or bring in to be a partner or be a part of my company, it was going to have to be about excellence. So the whole thing of excellence, my drive, my determination, coming from where I came from, definitely I wanted a better life for myself. I wanted an opportunity. And I didn't want anybody to just give it to me. I always use the James Brown phrase where he says, I don't want anybody to give me nothing. Just open up the door and I get it myself. And so that's been my mentality and my drive is that if you just give me that opportunity, I'm going to just go through the roof with it.
And you're very inspiring to a lot of people. The question I have for you is, Alonzo, do you feel that if you're a young African-American male today or female watching this and viewing this, that it's as difficult as in 1992 when you started your company? Do you still feel like people look at you differently because you're African-American?
I have to be aware of it. I have to be conscious of it. But I have to use that to drive me and to fuel me. So when you're looking at coming at 92, there were some doors that was closed in my face because I showed up to give an estimate and they didn't know I was black. there was people that didn't even answer the door because they were like, I didn't know the guy was black that showed up. And it's trust. It's, again, do I trust this particular young black man to actually come into my home and into my personal space around my personal belongings, and I'm going to let him in? So it's just, it's overcoming those things. I think when I look out and I speak to young black kids or young black teenagers or young black entrepreneurs, is that one, you're definitely going to have to prove yourself. You have to really earn, you have to earn it. You know, it's not going to be given to you. I think I've always had the mentality to say, I'm going to have to work twice as hard, you know, and work twice as hard, meaning I got to deliver on a higher level, not on an equal level, but a higher level.
I love your energy. Bill Rizzell loves you for a reason. You're contagious. I'm ready to run out of the den right now and just start. It's contagious. I love it. You know, what are you communicating to your customers right now? Because you're a leader in Westchester. You're not just a guy that owns a cleaning company. You're a leader. You're in the community. You're at the forefront. So can you kind of tell us what you're doing, telling people?
Well, you know, what's happening now is that the communication is huge right now. And the amount of communication is important. So the quantity and the quality is vastly important right now. So, you know, we're reaching out to our clients on a regular basis through emails. We're doing this through phone calls and just letting them know what we're doing internally through our education, our certification, and training that we're doing internally. Because people right now, they're not really sure how to combat these different this virus or how to interact with it. Should I let someone clean my home right now? And we're trained, we're certified. We understand how this virus works. We understand how to combat it. We have the proper equipment, the proper tools. We're coming in with the proper protection when we come into the home. That being, if that's going to be gloves, that's going to be face shields, that's going to be a face mask, that's going to be shoe covers. We're coming in and we're armed, we're equipped, we're ready. And it's not just with the equipment, because I'm seeing some of my competitors, they have caught on, they're watching what we're doing. They're coming in with the same equipment, but not with the same education and training. They're not knowledgeable what they're doing. They don't understand how to properly come into a home and disinfect into the home, which the average homeowner doesn't know how to disinfect either. They know how to sanitize, but they don't know how to disinfect.
You know, what are you working on right now internally to move your business forward? What are you saying? Okay, I got some slowdown time. Most businesses do. What are you working on internally?
Lance, we're working on everything from our processes internally, our systems, our procedure. We're just really working on how to really amp up our training. We want our business to be more automated. We're just really creating an opportunity for when this thing starts to take off, we're going to take off with it. We're ready.
As lucky as Westchester is to have you as one of their main leaders down there, what do you think makes a great leader?
A great leader, one, has to be resilient. That's the key thing. I always look for someone that's resilient because they can deal with the uncertainty. They can deal with the unexpected. The other thing I feel is important is to be a servant, because right now with all this going on, my position in my company, as well as being the head of a large association, I have to put myself to the side as I'm there for others, to care, to support, to guide, to encourage people to weather the storm. Because again, if they see you lose confidence, they see that you're being shook up. People start to fear starts to increase. So right now I'm encouraging people and I'm telling them, stay focused, keep your mind focused on the big picture right now, because this is temporary. We're going to get through this. And when we get through this, we're going to move forward. But again, you gotta be making chess moves here.
Absolutely. Well, you heard it here from Alonzo, leader, business owner, entrepreneur. He's moving his business forward. Thank you for being on the Den. Everyone stay safe out there. Alonzo, thank you so much. It was incredible to have you.
Now is the time to go on offense, okay? It's time, no more defense, let's go on offense. Take a look at your business right now and look at anything that you can improve in it, and take a step back and say, what can you improve in yourself as a leader? Because I've seen leadership falling off drastically here. And right now, leadership is needed, and it's needed more than it's ever been needed.